comrades, don't pay too much attention to those silly whistles and that handful of people.
You want that too.
People all over the world of different races, different religions, and different nationalities on every continent support the struggle of the Palestinian people. The only people who support them are racists and Zionists and colonialists and occupiers and imperialists. And the way the world is going, their days are numbered. But we must do more. We must do more, comrades, especially here in what we used to call the belly of the beast. Israel could not exist very long without U.S. economic and military support. Everybody knows that. Everybody knows of the hundreds of billions of dollars in economic and military aid that the Zionists get all the time. But let's make it more personal. That Israeli sniper who's shooting the martyrs, that Israeli sniper who shot Rezan al-Najjar, there's a 99% that he shot her with an M16. That is an assault rifle made for the United States Army right here. And it is the most common weapon carried by the Israeli Defense Forces. Those helicopters, those gunship helicopters that destroy people, kill children, tear homes and hospitals apart, made in the USA, most of them anyway. So I just want to make a little suggestion before I leave. You know, our comrade Kim Jong-un, the head of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, sometimes referred to as North Korea. Y'all know who I'm talking about, right? He's got a meeting with Donald Trump in a couple of days. And it was the struggle of the Korean people that forced that meeting. Don't be fooled. And we know that comrade Kim Jong-un has a lot of business along with defending his people at that meeting. But if he could just for a minute, if it's possible, just for a minute, divert from the agenda and say, Trump, President Trump, whatever, racist Trump, I have a message from the Palestinian people and the people of the world. Stop giving Israel weapons to murder our people.
Free, free Palestine.
Palestine will be free. We will win.